Hello, my name is Wunping. Today, I will be sharing my bug hunting setup and the software that I use. I hope that sharing this will motivate aspiring bug hunters to take a step forward to start their bug bounty journey. And also, for bug bounty beginners to know that they are on the right path. First of all, there are two main reasons for sharing my setup. The first reason is because I have received a number of inquiries with regards to my bug hunting machine. For example, what is my setup? What operating system am I using? What software do I use most of the time? The second reason is because very often, when I ask people what is really stopping them from bug hunting, they tell me all kinds of reasons. And the most common one is that they say they do not have a good enough computer that can be used for bug hunting, or they do not know what kind of setup they need to even get started. Well, the truth is, you do not need a fancy computer to start hunting for bugs. Personally, I have been using a second-hand Mac Mini with Intel Core i3 processor and 8GB RAM. It was just fine. I barely faced any difficulties during bug hunting. The reason for using Mac OS over Windows for bug hunting is because, personally, I am more familiar with the keyboard shortcuts for Mac OS, and I like to run everything directly on my machine instead of using a VM. In the past, when I just started out my career as a penetration tester, I used Kali Linux. I will always have a Kali Linux VM with me to perform all the different test cases. However, in bug hunting, I realized that running Kali Linux VM is a little waste of space in my case, since its file size will keep expanding and my Mac Mini only has 128GB of SSD. Moreover, in my bug hunting workflow, I don't use most of the tools that are packaged within Kali Linux, like those that are used for sniffing, password cracking, reverse engineering, and etc. In fact, I don't use many things during bug hunting. So, here's my bug hunting machine setup. For the main bulk of things, I use BirdSuite Community, which includes my most important tool, the HTTP proxy server and repeater. Intruder and decoder are pretty handy as well. I use Intruder to record video proof of concept very often. It provides a very clean interface, and if you grab the correct information, it can really make things very clear for the triager. To run BirdSuite Community, you need at least 4GB of RAM, as I mainly only use it as a HTTP proxy server and also make use of the repeater function. I have not faced any issues with it so far. I know many people like to use Chromium web browsers to conduct their security testing, but personally, I prefer to use Firefox. I have been using Firefox as my main web browser for conducting security testing since I started my career, so I just stick to it. I like to use Firefox containers and many other useful extensions that are available for download. For text and code editor, I use Sublime. It is super handy and super lightweight. Usually, when I want to analyze a JavaScript file, I will just download it and open it using Sublime. It has many useful extensions that you can install to easily format any minified JavaScripts. Since I don't have a BirdSuite professional, I don't have access to the Burp Collaborator servers. However, InteractSH is a very useful tool for testing for out-of-bound interaction. It is free and it works similarly to the Burp Collaborator server. If for some reason you cannot install it on your machine, you can also run it directly using their web client. For notes taking, I use Notion and I believe many bug hunters are using it too. It is cross-platform and you can use it while on the move as well. The way I use it is that I will create a page to store all the different programs that I am participating in. Then I will create a subpage for each program and store their relevant notes in them. Test account information, application architecture which I observed during my time testing it, bugs that were found but not reported because they need to be chained in order to demonstrate impact, such as open redirect and etc. Of course, I also have other software installed in my machine, such as Postman, Android Studio, Docker, and etc. But those are for more specific situations, like special cases, so I don't use them all the time. Those which I shared earlier and provided more details, they are my main setup, and I use them all the time when I hunt for bugs. while I have shared my bug hunting machine's setup, you do not need to follow them. You can use alternative software such as OWASP ZAP for HTTP proxy server and other application testing functionalities. Other text editor like Notepad++, other notes taking app like Obsidian and Evernote. It doesn't really matter as long as it gets the job done. With this, I have come to the end of my sharing session on my bug hunting setup and software used. I hope the information I have shared are useful to you, especially bug bounty beginners and aspiring bug hunters. Remember, not having a good computer for starting your bug bounty journey is not an acceptable excuse anymore. If I can find bugs using this machine, so can you. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. If you have any tips or if you want to share your setup as well, please add them in the comments. Have fun and keep hunting!